What's going on, guys? Warsh Elite here, bringing you guys another video. Future with mentoring. I do gotta put my foot in my mouth just a little bit. I think I did misspeak. It was probably out of emotion, not logically, which is what I hate to do. I try to make all decisions that I do logically, kind of calm down, think about it, and, you know, actually make a good decision. Not just base it off of raw emotion out of, you know, being in the moment. So, I'm not going to quit mentoring. I'm going to take a break. I'm going to take a good week or two off. There is a guy that I did have on my truck before who had to go home for a family emergency who is coming back. Was kind of waiting for me, but it'll be around another week or so, a week, maybe 2 weeks, and yeah, I mean, hopefully, like, I don't control who comes on my truck or not, but I will ask. Hopefully I can get him. If I do, I think that'll be the guy that I do come back mentoring for, to kind of ease into it, because I know he's a good guy. We did spend some time together, and we got along, you know, fine. So yeah, so I will, you know, just taking a little break, kind of clearing my mind, right? Which is always good, because, I mean, this industry is, it could get really stressful, especially on your mental, things that you have to deal with. It's just being the trucking industry in itself is extremely tough to succeed in. Owner operators' success rate is really low. The turnover rate is really high, you know, if you went to trucking school with somebody, you know, if you went to trucking school with like 10 people, probably like two out of the 10 are still going to be in trucking after a year. If you guys made it to a year, I mean, really give yourself a pat on the back, right? You've done what a lot of people just can't do for whatever reason, you know, whether, you know, it just be like financial reasons. Maybe you're not going to make a lot of money fresh out the gate. And a lot of people quit before they hit that gold mine of what trucking is. I mean, there's nowhere else you can make the money in trucking. I mean, you're making like lawyer money. You're making like, what's another good career? I mean, like IT money. Without a degree, without an education, you know, there's nowhere else you can get a job like that, a career like that. That has so little training and, you know, student loans to accompany it too. So, I mean, to even get into this, you kind of got to think a little bit ahead. I say this a lot of my videos. It's probably getting old and redundant, but it has to be said. You guys really have to take a look at yourself, what you want out of trucking, and set those goals and look at it and have that conversation with, you know, your girlfriend, your wife, your family, your kids. I mean, if you're single, this is the perfect industry to be single for. And the reason I say that is because I speak from experience myself. I'm all over the place, excuse me, but I'm going to hit my points, I promise. So I speak from experience myself. You know, I was a single guy renting. $1,500 alone rent in Vegas was what I was paying. Just to be living out of my truck, I mean, I'm saving like $2,500 at least in bills. So, I mean, if you're a single guy, I mean, this is by far the best industry for you. This is the best decision you can make by far. I highly recommend it. For any other situation, it gets a little bit stressful as well, you know, dealing with family and kids. I do not know how they do it. I have issues alone dealing with the stress and depression that comes with trucking. Which I have a really good system, support system for. So, if you guys do not have that, I'm sure it would be a little bit tougher. But, I mean, hopefully that's what I'm trying to bring to you guys with the community. Have somebody to talk to. I mean, have somebody to help you. Whatever you're kind of dealing with. I mean, I could cover a lot of topics myself that I've been through and that I have experience with. I mean, a lot of the issues you're dealing with is financial stuff. I got you. If you guys are dealing with, you know, trucking stuff, I got you. So, I mean, feel free. I mean, come join our community. Ask questions. Don't ever, you know, hesitate to reach out, you know, if you guys are dealing with that. So, anyways, I got really off topic on that one. I'm sorry. But the whole point was, if you make it to a year, in this industry. Congratulations, pat yourself on the back. This turnover rate in this industry is so high. It's not just a company thing, it's a trucking industry thing. It's insane, it is so high. So once you get to that year, a lot of, unfortunately, drivers start becoming cocky. They start thinking that they're super truckers. And I'm just pointing this out as a warning. Do not get complacent in this industry. So always keep challenging yourself. Always try to keep growing. The moment you become complacent is when you become a more dangerous driver. So, I mean, you're never going to be more dangerous than like a CR England or a Swift or CRST or whatever. You're never going to be that bad. But once you think that you are too good to start, you know, getting out and looking and stuff like that, that's when you're probably going to get a preventable that you wouldn't have had any other way, you know, just because you got a little bit too prideful to get out and look. There is nothing bad about getting out looking. And I mean, it's not worth, you know, getting a mark on your score. It's not worth, you know, the confrontation you're gonna have with that owner operator who has to get it fixed now. It's not worth it, guys. So anyways, my advice anyways is kind of keep challenging yourself, kind of keep growing. I struggle with blindsides because I hardly ever get to back anymore since I'm mentoring all the time. But when I get to back, I challenge myself. I try to do blindsides and things like that, just so I can get a little bit better at it, because I am getting, there are situations where you have to do it. Instead of taking like a half hour, I want to take, you know, 28 minutes instead, you know. So practice makes perfect. So I'm not going to quit mentoring. I'm just going to take a little break here for about a week or two. And I'm going to be working on a video. So I'm going to be doing some fun things. Hopefully you guys enjoy this next one. This video is probably going to be boring to a lot of you guys. You guys don't really care. But I got the green light on, so hopefully you guys come for the green light, and I'll see you guys on the next one. I'm sure the next one will be much more entertaining. This is more so of a letting you guys know I'm putting my foot in my mouth. I'm not gonna stop mentoring. I'm just gonna take a break, because you gotta understand, like, I've been mentoring for over a year or so. I've had like 30 to like 50, maybe 60, I don't know how many I've had. I don't know what my body count is. Weird thing to call it my body count, but I have no idea what my body count is of the ELDs I've had in my truck. But it's safe to say that I have at least, you know, 30 to 50, right? So of those, my relationships have been amazing with them. Two of them are even mentors now. They still call me and ask for advice. You know, I got this community on Facebook. I talk to a lot of these guys on the regular. So I mean, the impact I think I've made on people's lives, I think, is positive, you know. 96% roughly have been amazing, you know, students, ELD, relationships have been amazing. It's that 6% or whatever that have been bad. And it's not worth kind of throwing everything away for a very small percentage, right? So cooler heads do prevail.